In the hunt for natural gas, the clang of a pipe, the flick of a switch. Just another day on Ensign 146 in northern Pennsylvania.
What we're in the process of doing right now is laying down drill pipe.
But what is remarkable about this scene is what is not seen. Equipment brimming with sensors at a drilling site taking up less land, gnawing into the earth in a place once thought too difficult to extract gas.
What we have now, which is a tremendous amount of supply and potential supply that has yet to be tapped, it's changed the landscape in a major way. No longer are we talking about importing natural gas to the United States.
The Marcellus Shale Formation covers a swath of the Northeast, its rock trapping a bounty that could help make the U.S. the world's largest producer of oil and gas. It is a place of pastoral beauty, quaint small towns hosting an energy revolution.
Where the real work begins, much of the drilling remotely observed and in the near future remotely operated.
All of it watched with a few keystrokes from Shell headquarters in Houston, Texas.
The idea is first and foremost is well control, worst case being what happened on BP Horizon. But after that would be anything that takes away from actually drilling the well. The rigs run upwards of $1 million a day, so obviously anything that can keep drilling on the critical path is a benefit.
This is Shell Rig 1, almost fully automated, smaller, needing fewer workers. For now, work at the Hepler 6021H well grinds on.
We'll run casing, cement the well, and move over to the next one and all. We got three more wells on this pad right here.
Freeing gas from the shale rock below means fracturing it, fracking. That requires water and sand hauled in these cars, creating another boom at the tiny Wellsboro and Corning Railroad where traffic is soaring. All of this coming to a region looking for an economic boost. But does it come at a price? Roads worn by heavy trucks, worries about chemicals mixing with groundwater. Eric Coolidge is a county commissioner and a dairy farmer with a well site on his land.
The history that we have to appreciate from the timbering history, the coal history, could not repeat itself during the extraction of natural gas. I think we've done a darn good job at that.
Pipe by pipe, the old energy of fossil fuels found in new ways. Lee Powell, The Associated Press, Wellsboro, Pennsylvania.